Hi, Gap.
Hi, Steve. You okay?
Good, mate. You?
Good, fine. Yeah, thanks. Can we start off with any new team news going into the weekend, please?
No, nothing. Nothing out there. No, Ben Cabango, who I thought was excellent the other night, by the way, in a big game for him. A little bit of hamstring pain. He'll be getting checked out as we speak now. We haven't trained yet today, so the day's starting a little bit later. And Aldo is, as I've said last week, continuing through his rehab, making progress, but still a little way off from being ready to play.
Is Ben? I know he wasn't eligible the other night, but is Ben Wilmot okay?
Yeah, Ben. So you're right. Yeah, Ben's back training. He'll be out training with us today, and he would have been available if we weren't playing Watford the other night as well.
He had a little problem though, did he?
Yeah, he's had a bit of a slight recurring knee problem. It's nothing too major, but it can set him back a couple of days at a time. It happened against Cambridge first of all, where he carried on with the game. But he set him back after that for a few days. He picked it up again with England's 21s, set him back a few days there. He didn't return because he didn't need to. So it's a bit of a frustrating one for him, really, that he gets back into it. But the medics are comfortable that it will heal. I guess there was just it just happened at the wrong time last Friday, just before we left for Bristol. And the Watford game was Watford rather than anybody else in the country. So a little bit unfortunate for him at the moment because he's doing really well, Ben, in training. Probably hasn't quite had the game time that he would have liked. So it was a double whammy for him, a straw in Watford the other night, because it was a game we would have liked to have seen him in. Plus he would have obviously wanted to play, but he's a really good lad. We're really happy to have him here, and when his time comes, I know he'll be more than ready.
You've got a space to fill at left back, obviously. How do you assess your options there?
Yeah, well, we do have options. Declan obviously played the other night, and did well against Watford. We know that Kyle has filled in there before as well. Ben Wilmot is somebody that can play anywhere across the back four. Grimes has played there before as well last season, so we're not short of options to fill in the gap. The key to it is, as always, trying to pick the right team for the right game plan, and that will be the case.
Talking of fullbacks, you left Connor out of the side last weekend. Was that a fitness thing or a rest thing or tactical?
Bit of everything, really. I think we're quite blessed with right backs, with having Connor and Kyle at our disposal, we felt it was a game that Kyle could excel in and did. But we're really happy with Connor. He's played a lot of games, including international football. He didn't have a massive break because of the trip with Wales at the end of the season, but through the summer, really. So it's just about, as I said before, we've got a group of players training every day that, are more than capable for playing in the next game, whatever that is. And it was just an example of changing things about for the game. But he came back in on Tuesday. I thought he was really good. And we look forward with all of the players.
You appealed the Bidwell red card. I think you said it was, after the game, you said it was a clear yellow. Mm. What did you make of the fact that the appeal failed?
I still stand by our views on the decision. Particularly, when you look at the tackle on Selena in more detail. That makes it double frustrating that they can see that as a straight red and the one in the first half as not. That was double a dangerous and higher tackle. I get that they're different situations and they will only look at the incident as independently for what it was. I get that. So that does make it double frustrating on that from that point of view. We didn't have massive hope that they turn it over because they don't tend to be, So listen, we'll deal with it. We still feel harshly dealt, particularly Jake. But if that's a challenge to overcome, we will.
It didn't appear a particularly dangerous challenge.
But it wasn't.
That's what it has to be, isn't it? A serious foul play it has to be in order to be a red card.
Exactly. And I guess that is a frustrating thing, but. Yeah, and like I say, it's easy to get even more frustrated for the players, myself and the coaching team, when you see what happened on the other side of the pitch in the first half. But we're not the first not the first team to be harshly dealt with on the, you know, the wrong end of some poor decisions. We just, we're over it. We look forward. We've played a game since and we move on.
Do you just, lastly on that, do you get any sort of explanation of why the appeal failed?
Not so much on the appeal, but you know, you can, and we did fill in a referee's report after the game, and we do that because we want the referees to grow as much as the game. And then if you do make some comments on decisions that you disagreed with, you do get some feedback on that, which we haven't received yet. We did fill in a referee's report with our views, and you'll see what they come back with. But I go back to, listen, there'll be games this week where there'll be decisions that will be disagreed with, and the week after, and it's just part of the game. But we're over it, and we're, like I said, we're looking forward.
At least you haven't got VAR to contend with.
Yeah.
This week, decent performances, but not the results you wanted, obviously.
No, and that's what we're trying to do, is trying to focus very much on performances and believe that if you get the performances right, then, you know, the results will come. As I said after the Bristol City game, I think there was spells of that where we were as good as we've been really all season, and I think we were more than good for winning the game. But we didn't. But you know, we reflect accordingly. We looked at the good things we've done, where we can improve, and we go forward. And I thought we took that into Tuesday night at Watford, a bigger stage, if you like. They put out they made some changes obviously from the Man City game, but they still had a very much Premier League team. Kept some players in, and again, as I said, I feel the same as I did straight after the game. I thought we were much the better team, and probably fell on the wrong side of some defining moments inside the box. You know, Sam could have got his second goal, and you know, the one in our box ends up going in, and maybe that is a learning from playing against a Premier League team, is the defining moments. You've got to try and make sure they work for you, not against you. But lots of positives to take from the game, individual performances, team performance. Like I said, we're in good form here now, back at Fairwood, getting ready for a home game on Saturday.
Is Surridge doing enough in the cup competitions? His record's very good. Is he saying to you, I should be in the league team?
I think lots of the players, well, most of the players who have not played as much as they'd like, are very much knocking on the door. There's no doubt about that. And Sam is somebody that's showing that, you know, when we call upon him, he's ready. I think he's shown that when he's come on a substitute as well. Listen, he hasn't come out to be a sub, and we're not looking at him as a sub. It's just a team that we're picking at the moment. And you know, we're very happy with the two strikers that are playing at the moment, and we know other players can play there as well. So is he doing enough? Yeah, he is. You know, and I'm sure that some more starts won't be that far away.
Defensively, the numbers say as a team you're doing well. The record is very good. Attacking wise, maybe in the last three games, not as much threat as you would have liked.
I think we did look a threatening team against Bristol. You know, and I think, you know, if there's any areas where you look to improve, would be about turning them into goals. Forest, the week before, yeah, we didn't hit the heights in terms of the last part of the pitch. And we knew that. We knew that during, even straight after the game, the players didn't need to be told. But the fact that we did look an offensive team again against Bristol was pleasing. And like I said, on another day, we could have scored a few through set plays as well. We had, you know, some good first contacts from our corners in the second half. If we weren't creating chances, then, you know, you would be a little bit more concerned, but I'm not, because I'm seeing the work that's been done in training, now the players are performing. And like I said, we were a threat last week against Bristol. We scored a great goal against Watford. And as I said, had a really good chance to score another one, to score two goals, you know, away at the Premier League club would be a good return. So, yeah, you know, we're positive going forward that we will create and score goals.
You mentioned the Forest loss, the first league defeat at home since Boxing Day, an amazing run. The challenge now is to try to start a new one against Reading this weekend.
Yeah, it is, Gareth. But, you know, as I said, while that run was ongoing, that, you know, you just because you're winning games and you're on the end of a on the end, you're, you know, you're continuing a home run, doesn't mean that you're just going to win the next game. You've got to treat every game for what it's worth, and you know that will be the case against Reading on Saturday. We'll be well prepared. You know, we do enjoy playing at home, so we want to make the most of it. And like I said, come Saturday, I'm sure that the boys will be ready to deliver.
Yeah, the record says you enjoy being at the Liberty. It'll be good to be back there.
Definitely, yeah, definitely. You know, there's nothing like playing at home with the crowd right behind you and trying to play the best football possible and working as hard as you can when you haven't got the ball. They're our aims in any game, but if we can do that with our guys, you know, in the stand behind us, right behind us, then, you know, it's where you want to be, you know, making the most of being at home. So, you know, we're confident that Saturday can be that, and we'll be working our hardest to ensure it.
What sort of challenge will Reading present, do you think?
Technical team, no doubt about that. I actually think they've played better than what their recent results have shown. You know, they've created good chances in every game that they've played, and very much want to play from the back and play through the lines. And if you let them, they can be a dangerous team. So so we need to be, and we are very aware of that. You know, so the players are back in today after the trip back from Watford, and we'll be laying down the game plan while reminding the boys of what we expect from any game that we play in terms of the playing style and the commitment, and we'll be ready to play. But I think what I've quickly learned in this league, that every game is a challenge in one way or another, and this will be a different one. As I said, technical team can be a threat offensively, and you know, we have to be at our maximum.
Fans will look at the table where you are, where Reading are. There may be some expectation on your team this weekend, maybe a new thing to deal with.
Yeah, and I think, you know, even in like the last couple of games that we've played in the league, we've seen teams change systems and players, a lot of personnel change. And I just said to the boys, just, you know, that's the opposition's prerogative. They can do what they want. What we've got to do is not let that be the beating of us, and see it as a compliment, really, and thrive off the challenge. So whether that's the case on Saturday, I don't know. But if Reading come playing the way they have been playing in recent games, we'll be aware of that. If they do change things, then, you know, we have to quickly adapt. Regarding the league position, I think that's dangerous to think too much about that, because there's always a few results every week that surprises you. I think that's the nature of the Championship. And like I said, you pay too much attention to that, then it can quickly smash you in the face. So, you know, we'll be mindful of just doing our job.
But you've noticed already, have you? You think that teams are changing their approach when they're facing Swansea City?
Well, they have in the last two games. Certainly changed personnel. So, like I said, it's the nature of the league, isn't it? You get a different challenge every single game. What we've got to do is make sure that we are capable of playing in any type of game. Of course, our first idea, you know, we want to be dominating games. We want to be earning the right to play with the ball. But that's easier said than done. And if teams want to do the same against us, we have to defend properly. If teams want to drop off, then we've got to be good enough to play through and not get done on counter-attacks. So we're talking about it a lot, doing a lot of work on the grass, and hoping that when the games come round, we're well prepared for whatever comes. And there's no right or wrong way of setting up a team for game plans. We just want to make sure that we're focused on ourselves and dealing with what's in front of us while trying to play our way.
Can I ask about Chris Peterson?
Yeah.
Probably hasn't played as much as he would have liked. He's in an interview with a Swedish paper this week. He said as much. He stressed that he didn't want to be seen to be complaining, but admitted he was a bit frustrated with the lack of game time. What do you make of his contribution so far?
Yeah, I saw the interview. I agreed with everything that he said, to be fair, including, you know, moving from a different country with a different playing style, different culture, and taking a little bit of time to settle in. And that's what it's been. And Chris is here for the long term. I really believe in him, and I really believe in what he will bring to the football club, both short and longer term. it's just a matter of him working as hard as he is, you know, every single day, like everybody else in the group, and being ready to deliver when he plays. But he's not on his own. You know, there's lots of players in the squad that would have liked to play more than they have. Some not even getting changed at the moment. So, but that's a nice problem, certainly for me, that we've got players of that ilk who are, you know, not playing as I said, much as they'd expect to play and as they want to play. But knowing if we do call on them, they'll be ready. And I think that's the culture that we want, and that's the level we want to be at. And, you know, Chris will keep his head down, keep working hard, and hopefully take his opportunities as and when they come.
Do you think it's simply a case of him needing some time then? I know he was in English football as a youngster, but to adapt to senior level English football?
Maybe. I say there's no rush with him, and we're happy with how he's settled in and how he's progressing. We're happy with his performance levels in training, but as I say, he's not on his own. You know, there's not one player I'm looking at in training, or games, and feel like they're doing their own thing or they're not part of what we're trying to do. I feel like we're all together as one, and you know. Chris will know that as well. Like I said, I agreed with his comments. You know, he's an honest boy, and he can, you know, he's desperate to do well. We're desperate for him to do well. So it's just a matter of carrying on with his work. And, you know, 46 plus games a season, including Cup, everybody's going to be needing, I'm sure of that.
Thanks a lot, Steve.
See you, guys.